begins in the first 5 minutes of first period.
What kind of a number do I have? Is it a composite number, a prime number, or a square number?
Square.
It continues throughout the day.
36, 66.
Is it one square, though?
In history class.
We're going to measure the length of Titanic outside.
Art class.
Whatever you make has to be cut out
symmetrically.
Computer lab.
And the next one?
Four.
And it ends in last period music class.
We're going to take the math idea of below zero and turn it into music.
It is part of most everything that happens at Fullerton 4. A K-5 school in Roseburg, Oregon, it is...
But prime would be only times in it by one, so it can't be any number at all.
The magic of math.
You are absolutely correct.
To me, math is really not a subject. It really allows kids to learn how to reason and problem solve and learn how to effectively communicate.
Now, music is sound, so what would be the opposite of sound? Yeah.
Silence.
How many?
And if they can think conceptually, it opens up not just math, it opens up thinking. It makes connections for them in the real world.
Now remember to put some silence in your pattern.
It allows them to explore music and art, and so math is really the foundation.
Oh, I see some really wonderful positive negatives, just like those math numbers. Great.
With all the engaging ways to learn here, it's not surprising most Fullerton students say...
My favorite subject is math.
I'm doing math.
Probably math.
Math.
I like math a lot.
Probably soccer.
Probably reading and math.
I just like to add and subtract.
What's your second favorite subject?
Playing with friends.
I like division the most.
Math.
What do you like to do in the classroom?
Probably math.
My favorite subject is actually math.
How come?
I just like it.
Oh, and we raise a quiet hand if you notice something. Give everyone...
Fullerton's math curriculum is based on a continuous review of best practices and delivered by highly trained teachers beginning in kindergarten.
Tell me about green, blue, green, blue, green, blue.
It's a pattern.
It's a pattern. The kids will look for me oftentimes for the answer. And I can give them the correct answer every time. But what I want them to do is to talk their way through the problem. Whisper to your neighbor what you notice about this. We use a word at our school called discourse. And it's the ability for kids to communicate back and forth between each other so that they can start to understand that problem or communicate it to me.
Do you think it's still a pattern?
No. If you just took this part off and put the green in the middle and then the blue on the top, it would be a pattern.
This would be a pattern.
Since the new math curriculum was instituted in 2000, math test scores have soared. Now 98% of third grade students score at or above grade level. This despite the fact that the number of students on free and reduced lunch has also climbed to 60%.
When you look at children that have personal life struggles, too often adults make excuses and minimize their ability to learn. And one of the things that I said to the staff is socioeconomics does not put a cap on achievement.
So there's about how many possibilities?
100.
Very good. Excellent.
To further support math instruction, the district provides a part-time math coach in master teacher Mike Gould.
We've come to the realization that everybody can learn mathematics. And it's not a question of capacity anymore. It's a question of how you deliver it and how you allow people to think about it.
You gotta hone in on those thinking skills.
I think a perfect example is 4.5 divided by 1.5. What's the first thing that comes into your mind?
I have no clue.
Yep, that's the typical answer. Where if you were to hear a story, if I have $4.50 and I'm going to give $1.50 to each of my friends, how many friends do I have? Well, it's an obvious answer of 3, rather than, oh, I can't do this. I never did understand how to flip and invert and multiply and all those other weird things. So it's making the mathematics come alive.
3 days, -4.
Everybody has an avenue to learn. We just have to find that right avenue.
Yeah.
Everybody includes the students in Steph Neihardt's Alternative Learning Center.
And the program is for kids who have emotional, behavioral, maybe social disorders that get in the way of their learning in a regular classroom setting.
I want you to walk up there and stand where you think 100 feet is.
And the goal is to help these kids to learn and to be passionate and excited about learning.
Well, that's what we're learning here, is how to estimate.
With help from some of their friends,
think that's 100 feet?
Mrs. Neihart's charges set out to measure off the Titanic, all 882 and a half feet of it, in their own backyard.
We began by researching it and gathering books and looking at pictures and doing some internet studies. And our goal initially was to write about it. But in that process, we came up with all this math.
Hey, you guys were really close. Your estimates have gotten a lot closer. That's incredible. Go ahead and mark that.
We discovered that the Titanic was 882 and a half feet long, and we realized we had no idea what that was.
We're at 800, so we kind of got to shift gears here, don't we?
When you do a project like this, I'm always impressed with the long-term effects of the learning and how it incorporates so many different kinds of math into it.
1, 2, 3, 61.
These are also hands-on learners, most of them, and they prefer to be able to be doing things when they're learning. And so it gets them very excited about it.
Let's look and see. Is there any
color? They love math.
See that white square down there? Can you imagine a ship that is that long? How can a ship that big float? Maybe that's our next investigation.
What we're going to do today is I'm going to give you a problem.
Teachers are excited about math here, too.
And so the problem is 133 subtract 87. You have to do it at least three different ways.
Ongoing workshops like this one bring teachers of all grade levels together to hone their craft.
And I knew if I put the 80 with the 100, it was an automatic 20. It was an easy number for me to work with. And then that left me with the 7 that I didn't use. If I put it there, it was confusing, so I put it with 30.
As adults, what we were taught, we didn't have to justify why. We just had to get the right answer. And quite often, we didn't. You know, I'm speaking for myself. I didn't know how to get the right answer. It just showed up.
So I'm breaking it apart into place values as well as using common numbers that I understood.
Our school district did a phenomenal job of adopting a curriculum that allows children to communicate about math. And then they trained us. And they trained us really well.
Get each one to 100 and then add those two numbers that we wanted to know.
Benchmarks.
Everyone is on the same page. Everyone's really working together really well. And I think that's what it takes.
You need to think like your kids, because they will come up with that wacky idea, and darn it, it's going to work.
Absolutely.
In addition to wacky solutions to math problems, Fullerton students came up with a unique solution to a problem many schools face.
Our custodians work hard, but we've been cut in all areas of support. And so I said, what do you want to do? And they said, we could go and clean classrooms. And so they now know how to clean blinds the right way and clean countertops and clean desks. I mean, they have it down, and they make a huge contribution.
Nearly half of the students here regularly spend their midday recess cleaning desks, scrubbing floors, and raking leaves in exchange for small treats and a chance to have lunch with the principal.
You have children who have never had to follow directions and do a careful job. They've never had to listen to another student and actually follow that student's direction. And so they're getting a sense of what a work ethic really looks like on a day-to-day basis in a bigger arena.
Oops, sorry.
Whether the problems are big or small, the common denominator for success at Fullerton seems to be math.
My number is even, so you could just cross off all the odd rows.
To listen to children actually say, this is what I was thinking when I solved this problem, and here's why I thought that, and for them to learn how to listen to each other, it goes beyond math.
You can solve small problems, still have time left to play.
It really allows them to be great problem solvers, and my personal belief is, if you can problem solve in life, you can do anything you want.
Big finish.
For more information on what works in public education, go to edutopia.org.